Hello and welcome to Gabala in Azerbaijan, International Shooting Sport Federation third Rifle and Pistol World Cup of the 2017 season. Day four, and it's the 50 meter rifle prone men final that's going to start in a couple of minutes. I'm Matthew Layton. As you can see on my screen, my guest from Azerbaijan, Kayala Husseli. Hello. Yeah.
Hello, how are you?
Good, thank you. Let's go through the actual one athletes at a time. Listen to what James is saying. He's introducing the individual athletes. Thomas Mattis is first to go.
Yeah. Noch Baller, Jen from Switzerland.
And here we are at Fahrenheit. Representing Switzerland, he's won junior gold medals at the European Championships in both the 50-meter rifle prone and concussions. He also holds a World Cup bronze in that latter discipline. It's Jan Lobbila.
And Jan Lobbila from Switzerland. This is his first final in this event. Good Swiss presence.
On to firing point C, representing France. He's the Free Nations Olympic bronze medalist from Rio 2016 and also on gold in the same discipline this year in the Munich World Cup. This is actually his first World Cup 50-meter prone final today. It's Alexis Reynaud.
Alexis Reynaud from France also made the air rifle finals. This is first final at this level.
So firing point D, representing the Russian Federation. With a total of three World Cup medals across the disciplines, two bronzes and a silver, let's welcome to Gabala, Fedor Vlasov.
Fedor Vlasov, experienced shooter from Russia.
On firing point E, representing Belarus, with World Cup final silver, World Cup gold, and appearances at three Olympic Games, please welcome Yuri Shevchenko.
Yuri Shevchenko from Belarus, very experienced, as we've heard, three Olympic Games behind us.
On we go to firing point F, representing Belgium. He has a World Cup bronze to his name, as well as Olympic silver from London 2012. Please welcome Lionel Cox.
Lionel Cox from Belgium, in his second final, however, is an Olympic medalist from London.
On firing point G, representing Denmark, with 13 World Cup medals, World Cup final gold, and Olympic silver, it's Torben Grimmel.
Torben Grimmel, big cheer, the most well-known athlete in this final, with five Olympic Games behind him.
And here we are at firing point H, representing Great Britain. This is his sixth final at a World Cup. His second appearance in Gabala, and he took a silver medal last year in Baku. It's Kenneth Parr.
Kenneth Parr from Great Britain, a small contingent from Great Britain, and he has a medal here before in Azerbaijan.
Let me tell you, the jury member in charge of this final is Olga Stepanova of Azerbaijan.
Stepanova from Azerbaijan.
And the chief brains officer for this final is Piero Benatti of Italy.
Benatti from Italy, chief range officer. So the athletes. So, Hayala, what are the athletes thinking? They're just about to get ready. What is going through their mind?
Actually, I wonder about athletes because I can't choose any. I'm natural because I'm shooter too, and I want to compete in final, but just only men.
What are they thinking? Are they nervous? Are they focused?
This athletes looking so excited, I think, because eight athletes in final and eight strong shooter.
You're from Azerbaijan?
Yeah, I'm from Azerbaijan.
Azerbaijan shooting, is it strong?
Yes, I think, but just we are all new in Azerbaijan. For example, Gabala Shooting Club has been operated since 2012 in the fast-growing region of Gabala, a historical center in Azerbaijan. Baku Shooting Center for new for us because 2015 has been operated.
Okay, so we're just about to start two series of five shots. It's going to be very quick, and we're expecting high shots. In the qualifications, Torben Grill scored a 6:30.2, which was way ahead of the opposition. 6:27.7 was the next save. 3 whole points ahead of the opposition. All European final here. Grimmel 10.7. Matisse only 9.4, which could be expensive. Vlasov 10.5.
Wow. 10.8, Cox.
Selina Cox from Belgium has experience at the highest level, and he's got a great start with 10.8. And your picture. Kenneth Parr. There's Jan in the first final in this event. So it's new to him. 10.5 with his first shot. Grimmel.
Lots of fun for Grimmel Torben from Denmark. I see.
Cox has some very, very good grouping in his shots, if you're looking at the detailed screen. So, Lionel Cox, 10.8, 10.3, 10.5. Alexis Renault, who was caught out with some technical challenges earlier in the week. They have now been fixed. They've had no problems the last 2 days.
From Denmark, Torben, looking great. 10.8. I think Grimmel and Lochbeiler better than
Well, we see the scores coming in. Torben Grimmel, 52.9.
So that was our first series
for Denmark. Shebatiza from Belarus, 52.5. They're all grouping. So four athletes in the 52. Finishing with a 10.8. So you think they're good scores?
Yeah. 10.5, 10.3, 10.6, 10.8.
So that's
amazing.
The first series out of the way.
I think for 50 meters, prone position, very easy. But this point.
They're making it look easy.
Yeah, yes. Than other position.
Shevacevic.
Well.
So Cox is putting forward a good range, and Grimmel also 10.5. He first competed in the Olympics 17 years ago. So to keep at this level is quite remarkable.
Athletes from France want to arrive other athletes.
This year, this weekend, there's a you see the close-up camera next to Torben Grimmel. Yesterday we were putting on A, gives you a new perspective of how the shooters are actually showing. Grimmel's just had a 9.5, which is not going to help him. That's why he's come down. He had 10.8, 10.5, and 9.5, which put him out. And the Russian, Shebatsevich, with a great scoring, 10.5, 10.6, 10.8.
Try for world records.
Lobila is very consistent from Scotland, from Switzerland, of course. Alexi Raymore, great results in 3P. And Kenneth Parr from Great Britain, which might be called the UK in the future, is also performing high levels. It's a 10.8. So Mateus, Thomas Mateus from Belgium, struggling a little bit. But some great, great shooting from the Russian. Second series, good high series, better than the first series. Shabatsevich is leading with 105.3, so 0.5 ahead of Cox from Belgium. Grimmel had a 9.5, which didn't help him, but he's still there with 104.7. Thomas Mattis from Bell from Austria is really struggling. He's nearly three points back. Single shots, and we're going into elimination. So this is where the tension, I guess, is growing. The tension for the athletes.
Yes.
How do you manage the tension when you're doing this?
When
So when you're in this position, do you like it or do you not like it?
From position?
Yeah. Do you feel the stress or do you feel the excitement?
I'm new for three position because we have not only prone for men. Because tomorrow, yesterday, men is compete with prone position. But we have only three position. I'm falling in love prone because that's easy than other position, I think.
That's good. Section of high scores coming in.
5 seconds.
As there's some technical problems, the officials are calling the last few seconds. They all managed to shoot off. Shabatsevich continuing his good performance, 0.6 up. Thomas Mattis from Austria is struggling now. One more shot and two of the first elimination. So the first elimination is going to come in the next shot. You like the elimination system?
Yeah. Just my favorite from Belarus.
All eyes on fine point A from this Mattis. Bronze medal in Munich a few weeks ago. It's not going to be enough today.
5 seconds.
Jan Lobila with a 10.9. That's the first we've seen.
Wow.
So he made the final. It was a very competitive start.
Seven athletes remain battling it out for the medals. And a 10.9 we have there. The Jan Lobila of Switzerland remains in place.
Good crowd from Switzerland in today.
Roll it out, athletes. Looking so positive. And I think ready for next competition. Good luck him, by the way.
Hello. Start.
So two shots until the next elimination. Sivic, 32 years old, started competing 17 years ago. Lopila, who we saw have a 10.9 in his last shot.
5 seconds.
Followed up with a 10.5, so he's on form. Alexei Reno now in the hot seat. He is 0.8 behind Vlasov, one of
1-5, no change in terms of our positions. The next shot is to decide.
Next shot is going to be elimination. And France have 0.8 points behind. This is where there's a lot of tension.
Yeah. Start.
Vlasov has an advantage of 0.8. Par with a safe 10. Gumbel 10.4, at the moment he's 4th. Vlasov 10.4. Raymond 10.4, it's not going to be enough. And Cox a great 10.8 for Belgium. He now moves into first position. Alexei Reno,
wow.
2 finals out of 2 so far this week.
Yeah. Young athletes slowly roll it out. That's good experience for me, by the way.
It's good experience for them or for you?
Yeah.
It's great to have a guest from Azerbaijan, so we can understand.
For me too, thank you.
Start.
Grim in your picture. So far, last 3 shots have been 10.5, 10.3, 10.4. He's in 3rd position with 1.1 off the lead. Par 10.7, that's going to help him out because he was 0.2 off the lead.
5 seconds.
10.2 from Lockmiller. So it's switching around now. Equal 155.6 between Vlasov and Parr. This next shot's going to be elimination. Very tight right throughout. 1 point between the top 5 athletes.
This is shot 16 now for 6th place. For the next competition shot, low.
Par in your picture. Equal Vlasov from Russia.
Critic. For Fedor.
Well, Par's been shooting quickly as a 10.3. Crucially, we need to look at Vlasov. A 9.8, so Vlasov is out.
Stop.
Oops.
And 6th place representing the Russian Federation goes to Fedor Vlasov.
Fedor Vlasov takes the 6th place for Russia. Still really, really tight.
Fedor looking so sad, just. Oh, I'm angry. Good luck, Fedor. We believe you. Next competition, hope.
So for the Azerbaijan athletes, we're watching this today, watching the best athletes in the world. Will this inspire you? Will this push you forward?
My favorite.
For the Azerbaijan team, do they like watching this, the top level?
Okay, a rifle or pistols?
Everything.
Everything. Our top athletes. Okay.
They like watching this level. They can be inspired by watching great competition.
For example, our strong athletes. We have lots of.
Here we go. Let's go back to the board. Par 10.6.
10.7, Cox. Wow, 10.8.
5 seconds.
Jane.
Stop.
Lobula is moving up the line. So again, very, very tight. Kepar is moving up the board, but still equal with Sherbatsovic. But 0.9 between the top four, top five. Elimination shot coming up. So it's finishing in the worst position. Kepar normally the first to shoot. Out of 10.5. Sherbatsovic. 10.6. Wow. It looks like. I have to see how the others 10.1.
Oh,
by 1.1. Kepar ruled out 0.1. He was really, really close there. And just 0.9 between the top athletes. Down to the top four. It's just so close. A gap. 0.2 between Cox and Sherbatsovic. So Torben Grimmel at the top, 0.3 ahead of Lobila. Cox, 2.2 back and 0.2 back. Sherbatsovic from Russia. Lobila in your picture. Nina, who's going to be joining us in the commentary of the women's men's 3P, 2 days' time. Gimbal 10.4. Lobila's had a 9.6. That's not going to help at all. That's going to hurt, as you can see, 10.4, 10.7. Cox now is the gap at the top to 0.2. To decide the person who's going to take the fourth place, Lobila with his 9.6 as now 0.4 back off the pace. Jamie encouraging the crowd to give a bit of movement. I don't seem that motivated. They seem completely into the competition. Four athletes next. Sherbatsovic has an advantage of 0.4 over Lobila.
Exciting moments.
Grim 10.1. Sherbatsovic. Lobila's out. Well, taking the fourth place in his first final is Jan Lobila. Well done.
Bye bye, Jan. See you next final.
Well, we know the medalists now. Grouping within 0.3, two on top.
Same score for Denmark and Belarus.
Absolutely. Only 0.3 between the first three. There's Grimmel in your picture. All three of them have considerable experience at Olympic level. Two shots to go.
Oops.
An 8.9 from Lionel Cox. silver medalist from London. That's going to hurt. As you can see, now 1.3 back, but we have a tie for the top spot. So this is to decide the bronze medal. Tension at its absolute maximum here. So a series of 10.7, 10.3, and 8.9. This is Lionel Cox's second final at this level. Came ninth, just missing out in Munich. Oh, here they go. Cox has a huge 1.3.
I think it will be changed again.
Cox, wow. 10.7.
Cox backs for preference.
Well, Lionel Cox, both Wimmel and Shevachevic only doing it 9.9, so it's 2-2-8.4. So third place for Belgium. Well done. So two shots left. There's a lot of tension there.
For the next competition shot, load.
By the way, Cox looking so regrets.
Start.
So speeding up the tackle. Two shots left and they're both equal.
Very excited moment. Gold medal goes Wimmel. To which country?
Two shots. Grimmel has an advantage now of 0.2. Last shot to go.
0.2 separates the athletes in question with just one shot left. It all comes down to this one shot to rule them all.
32-year-old Shevachevic against 41-year-old Grimmel. Three Olympics against five Olympics.
For the next competition shot, load.
So Grimmel, a 0.2 advantage going to the last shot.
Start.
Ten needs a 10. Oh, finishes in 10.7. Well, that is justice. Grimmel won the qualifications by over 2 points, and so he takes Grimmel, who ties the world record, 249.8. Looks absolutely spent. Well, this is the second tied world record we've had. Christian Wright's tied in the 25 meter rapid fire yesterday.
So we're just gathering our medal winners together for the cameras, and we'll take you through them again, ladies and gentlemen. Here we go, the medal winners of the 50 meter rifle permanent men's event.
Congratulations, athletes.
Lionel Cox takes the bronze for Belgium.
And the silver medal representing Belarus goes to Yuri Shevachevich.
Yuri Shevachevich. Cut his hair, taking the silver medal for Belarus. And the well-deserved victor today. Torben Grimmel takes the gold medal, a very popular winner. So, Hayala, have you enjoyed the competition?
Yes, but I don't understand why gold medal is Torben looking so excited, because Finnish final, why? Maybe when I will be in final, I will understand. this situation.
So, for you, for someone from Azerbaijan, has it been a good competition?
Yes, I think. And I ask same question to you. Do you like this organization?
I think Gabala has done very well. I think the magnificent finals hall has done really well. There have been a few challenges. We've had some flooding and had some other problems. But no, the welcome and the hospitality has been really top-notch. So thank you for Azerbaijan. You put on a wonderful event.
Yes. Thanks, Matthew, for all. And just I turn back to my city, capital of Azerbaijan, Baku. See you next competition. Thanks for all.
Thank you very much. You can see the victory there, and we'll join you in about an hour's time for the air pistol women. Thank you.
The bronze medal representing Belgium goes to Denmark goes to Torben.